Accounting term. Some accounting term. Some accounting term. One was liquidity. The other one was solvency. The other one was depreciation. The other one was appreciation. The other one was useful life. That is salvage value. What? Salvage value. The other one was useful life. The other one was and then asset and liability. Let me just go over this quickly from the last class. I explain all these terms because you can't do accounting in agriculture without talking about this. So let me just explain this accounting terms in agriculture. The first one is liquidity. This is the ability of the farm to meet the financial commitment at the policy. That is the definition of liquidity. The ability of the farm to meet its financial commitment at the old deal. That is the definition of liquidity we did the last time. The ability of the farm to meet its financial commitment at the policy. I'm just recapping. I'm not giving notes today on this. The next is solvency. Solvency is the ability of the farm to recover the liquidation of its assets. Solvency is the ability of the farm to recover the liquidation of its assets. The next one, again, I talked about the last time, is depreciation. Depreciation is the decrease in value of a farm asset. Examples of farm assets that depreciate. Your tools can depreciate because of usage. Your animal can depreciate because of sickness. Appreciation is the increase in value of farm assets. Appreciation is the increase in value of farm assets. That's appreciation. Your land can appreciate. We used to buy land, let's say, at 20 years ago. 20 million and so forth. I'm not sure at our value we have kept that at 100 million now. So it has appreciated. Increase in value. Okay? Farm animals can appreciate. A sheep will cost 5,000. But if that sheep is here into a fowl, the fowl will cost up to 60 to 70,000 a matter of fowl. So animals also can appreciate. A young sheep can buy that 5,000. Here it will become a fowl. Salvage value. What salvage value? Salvage value, this is the money we cover from the sales of an asset that has little or no use to the farmer. Or salvage value is the money we cover from the sale of an asset that the cost of maintenance is too high to the farmer. For example, if I have a mobile phone and the phone costs 1 million and so I have a problem with the phone, for me to repair the phone, it will cost me 950,000. So I will sell that phone to recover something. Rather than for me to go and pay 950,000, that cost of maintenance is too high. When the cost of the phone is just 1 million. So why can't I sell the phone and then add what I have and buy another phone? So that is what we call salvage value. Money recovered from the sales of an asset that has little or no value to the farmer, or money recovered from the sale of an asset that the cost of maintenance of that asset is too high. Useful life. Useful life is the number of years an asset effectively serves a farmer. Useful life is the number of years an asset effectively serves a farmer. Asset. Agricultural definition, I'm giving you about all these accounting exams. Not your accounting you are doing in your financial account, your cost accounting. All the definitions I'm giving you, they are definition for agricultural property. Assets are property to the farm. Assets are property to the farm. And this property belongs to the farm. Example, land. Equipment. They are property to the farm and they belong to the farm. In agriculture, we have two types of assets. We have fixed assets and we have foreign assets. What are fixed assets? Fixed assets are properties in the farm that are not used up to the cost of production. Fixed assets are properties in the farm that are not used up during the cost of production. Example, land. You work on the land, the other thing I say, the land is available. Your machines and equipment, you can work with them this year, you still have them to work with. They are fixed assets. They are not used for doing the cost of production. We have foreign assets. These are assets that are used for doing the cost of production. Foreign assets are assets that are used for doing the cost of production. Example, fertilizer. Seed. If I have seeds I'm planting the farm presently, I have to use all the seeds. Next year, I have to buy seeds again. Fertilizer. I use all the seeds with fertilizer. Next year, I have to buy fertilizer again. So that is for foreign assets. Liability. Liability, according to agriculture, they are properties in the farm, but they belong to another person. They are properties in the farm, but these properties belong to an external person. Example, loan from bank. If you borrow money from bank, you have the money in your possession in your farm, but at the end of the year, you have to pay. So it's liability. It's a property in your hand that's in the farm, but does not belong to you, it belongs to the bank. Okay? Loan from cooperatives, loan from money lenders. These are all liabilities. Liability doesn't only mean money. Okay? For agriculture, we have three types of liability. We have short-term liability, medium-term liability, and long-term liability. What is short-term liability in agriculture? These are liabilities that must be paid from 0 to 6 months. That's what we call short term. Medium term, there are liabilities that must be paid from 2 to 5 years. Liabilities that must be paid from 2 to 5 years. And finally, the last type of liability is long term liability. Long term liabilities are liabilities that must be paid for 5 to 20 years. And these are huge amounts of money involved, like 200-500 million to invest on the farm. Within 5 to 20 years, you must have been to pay for them. Now, calculation on salvage value and depreciation. Calculation. Calculation on salvage value. Calculation on salvage value and depreciation. Okay? Total depreciation is equal to cost of assets minus salvage value. Salvage value. Okay? So, our limitation, is equal to cost of asset, minus salvage value, all over useful life. Cost of asset minus salvage value all over useful life. Okay? Copy the formula, please, and we'll take some examples. Come on.
Yes. Yeah. Okay, hi.
Okay, example, Mr. Master purchase a tractor for the school, in 1980 at the cost of, $50,000. In 1990, he decided to sell the tractor for $40,000. When he noticed that the cost of maintenance, was too high. Calculate what salvage value, two total depreciation. Three, annual depreciation. And then four, appreciation. So let's go back to the question again. Mr. Lachita purchased a tractor for the school in 1980 at the cost of $50,000. In 1990, he decided to sell his tractor for 40,000 euros. Why did he notice that? Because of maintenance was too high. Calculate 1. Salvage value. 2. Total depreciation. 3. Annual depreciation. And then 4. Appreciation. For the question quickly, I think I'm going to solve only one because of time.
Maybe this is the last.
Solution. Now, cost price, cost of the that money, 50,000 MS. Okay, cost price. Selling price is 40,000 euros. Okay? So useful life, how many other examples are that for useful life? Useful life is equal to from 1990 to 1980, it's 10 years, not 1995 to 1980, it's 10 years. So useful life is 10 years. So, what is number one? You can salvage value. Salvage value is equal to what? 40,000. That is salvage value. Why? Why is salvage value is 40,000? Because it is the money recovered from the sale of the asset that you are asking. When you notice that the cost of their maintenance cost was too high, so you decided to sell the tractor for 40,000. So total depreciation is equal to cost of asset minus salvage value. So what is the cost of the asset? 50,000 euros minus salvage value 40,000. So total depreciation. Total depreciation equal to what? 10,000 euros. So the capital depreciated for 10,000 euros. Now let's look at annual depreciation. Annual depreciation. Annual depreciation is equal to what? Cost of asset minus salvage value all over useful life. Or you can say annual depreciation equals to total depreciation all over useful life. You can use that as a formula. Okay? So this will be equal to cost of asset is 50,000 euros minus salvage value 40,000 euros all over useful life 10 years. So this will be equal to 50,000 minus 40,000 euros 10,000 euros. And divide that by 10. This zero and this zero will cancel. So our depreciation equals to 1,000 euros annually. Yearly. So in 10 years, the capital depreciation for 10,000 euros and total depreciation. So for 1 year, the capital depreciates for 1,000 euros. Every year, the capital depreciates by 1,000 euros. So the total depreciation is 10,000 euros. Annual depreciation is 1,000 euros. They are asking us for appreciation. Please, I'll give you 1 minute to write the answer for appreciation for me. Just 1 minute. I'm waiting for the answer for appreciation. What will be the answer for appreciation? What will be the answer for appreciation on the chat flow? Write your answer for appreciation. What do you think the answer will be for appreciation on the chat flow? Thank you. Is zero. Appreciation is zero. The top of the definition of appreciation is the increase in value. And Mr. Lange therefore says this startup of 50,000 and the startup was sold for 40,000. So there is no increase in value of the asset. The asset is appreciated. So if the asset of appreciation is zero. So we plan to do the next class to look at calculations of profit and loss and then balance sheet. We do some calculations on profit and loss and balance sheet. While we have a lot, we continue with the division and try to complete it and move to another topic. That's when we will complete it. We end the class here for today. See you. Well, let me say some things that are very much important. This is the last slide for this trial fix. This is the test case for this online teaching. Starting Monday, I think everything will change. We are in, you start to have something like a normal lesson as you used to have when you're in school. So, the trial fix has come to an end after the end of this agricultural class. No more calculate for the e-learning, which is a virtual classroom teaching. And we are to have a staff meeting at 12:30. The outcome of the staff meeting will determine the next move of this e-learning or virtual lesson. Please continue to share the information with others for them to be added in WhatsApp group. Send their numbers over in WhatsApp group so that I add them up. We are happy for the numbers you are getting up to 4 of the WhatsApp group before the school. And then we are moving to the 5th WhatsApp group now. So we are appreciating the commitment and also those who have been sharing information with others. Make sure you go to the YouTube page and subscribe for lessons you missed so that you can watch the past lessons and you can also download the past lessons. Submission of assignment starting next week will be on Saturday from 9 a.m. to 12. 9 a.m. to 12 on Saturday. No more submission of assignments from Monday to Friday. All assignments will be submitted on Saturday from 9 a.m. to 12. We are invited to be attendant to receive assignments on all subjects given to you. So make sure you are in school from 9 a.m. to 12. After 12, you come to the school, you must be nobody after 12 p.m. on Saturday. Not this Saturday now, subsequent Saturdays when we are thinking about giving you assignments or home activities.